Well, good evening. Join me this evening on the banks of my local river Ouse, where, as you can see, I'm under the shelter, so I can only mean one thing, I'm doing a night session. Mate Paul Burgess is down a little bit further. Got young Tom on the side, and Ian will be with me in a bit. He's going to fish just by the side of me, just on the right hand side, so I've left him a nice little bit of room. I came along here on one of my previous videos with mate John, fished a little bit further down with a fish side by side, and we said wonder what it'd be like at night. So it's supposed to be a nice evening. It's very, very muggy and mild, so hopefully we might get one or two fish. I've started off like I do normally. I've put 20 balls out, that sort of size, with the old wob dropper, sort of large tangerine sort of size. Tried to make them all roughly the same size, and they're all out by some lily pads, which I'll show you in a minute. And the grain bait I am using is the Bait Tech MV Green, and I've got the special G margin in there as well. As you can see, I've got some 4mm soaked 4mm pellets in there, and I've got some 2mm krill. Like I say, give that a squeeze. It doesn't sort of inflate like with air, so it doesn't expand, so you know that's just about spot on. Fishing like I normally do, I've got the old flatbed, so Matrix 45 gram flatbeds. This is the large elasticated stem, got my own elastic in it. A couple of them was wearing, so I've just changed my own. So that's what I'm fishing out there, 45 gram. I've got a few change in there as well. I'm using a short 4-inch hook length, which is a spare one with a couple of stots on, where I'm just fishing a little pop up off the bottom. That's 8-pound gravel braid, and I've got size 10 acolyte circle hook. And as you can see there, one of the Drennan bayonets. I'll just be pushing that in either a 10mm krillin tuna wafter. I've got some other ones, I've got some pineapple ones, I've got a bit of everything. I've got some 12mm, and I've also got some of my favourite juice 8mm, where you see there I've got a right mixture. So I've got a bit of everything really. Got some bottom baits, I've got some 10mm strawberry, which I've had soaking since the start of the year in some of the old Bait Tech red berry stick mix, and that's took it on in the boilers, are a lot softer now, so you know that's actually took the flavouring on as well. So they do smell really good, and I've caught one or two fish on them. So we'll just show you where we're fishing. So there we are, rods are out there. So I've got one round about there, and the other one is round about there. And all you see is a big line of pads all the way across there. And you got about 8 foot of water. So I've put all the bait along there. I'm not really bothered what happens now. It's more of a case of the bait's out there. Hopefully draw a few fish in for later on tonight. There's a lot of small fish topping, so there's a lot of rud out there. So most importantly, we're on the bank. Ian will be with me in a bit. I'll say Paul's down there, Tom's next door. Mick is just a little bit to the left, so hopefully might get one or two fish. Got the cooker, more importantly. Here we go, we have got quite a selection tonight, because I know Ian's coming. So we've got some granary rolls, we've also got some wholemeal rolls, but best of all, we've actually got some bacon. Be good to yourself, eat bacon. Beautiful. So that's all set for a bit later on. Like I say, I've had one or two indications, not really bothered at the moment, just want to get everything as I want it, have a brew, have a bite to eat, then settle down. I haven't got the bed chair tonight. See, I've got my chair simply because I'm fishing the feeder. I'm hoping that we have a restless night. But either or, this is quite a high back chair. It's really comfortable. Use it a lot in the winter for piking. And knowing me, I will nod off. After all, I worked last night, got back about 3:30 this morning. And yeah, I think I've had about 3 hours kip. but I don't really care, I'm fishing. So we're gonna see, everything's in place, the bait's out there, traps are set, as I always say, let's hope for one or two fish. But I'm gonna get everything sorted, ready to get a bit of tea on, and I will catch up with you in a bit. Come on, the fishies. Good evening. It is approximately, it's just come up for 11 o'clock. So what's been occurring so far? It's been quite tough going. Say the bait's out there. I've had three nice bream. I've also had two rudd. Ian came, we sat, had a bit of a social, if you like, together. Just sat by the side of me. He had a couple of nice rudd. There's been a lot of fish surfacing. So I'm just hoping they might get the head down. The river, the pace increased just a little bit. Oh, that's nice. The pace increased just a little bit. Not a lot. But maybe that unnerved them, I don't know. But there is a few fish about. Like I say, you can hear them boshing about and getting the odd liners. But you know, when you get a proper bite, that does tear off. So like I say, 11 o'clock, I would say up until maybe about 11:30, should be able to hopefully get one or two. But will they feed through the night? Don't really know. Other places I've been, yes I have. This is a bit different. Like I say, it's quite a tough bit of water on here to crack. But yeah, the rods are out, they're in the right place. Like I say, the beauty of it this time of the year is if you cast out and you hear it land, you know it's sort of somewhere near. As long as you hit that clip, it's sort of, you know what angle you've got to stand at to cast, you ain't going to be too far away. So hopefully we might get one or two into the night. But if we don't, fingers crossed, we'll get one or two as it starts to get light. We know they're out there, the bait's out there. Let's see what happens. And as for me, I will catch you tomorrow morning. That is a lovely brew, even if I do say so myself. Oh, bit of activity. Here we go. Is it going to happen? Let's see. Got a bit of activity. Oh, there we go. That was a liner. Never mind. Let's get the bait back out there. Let's get the bait back out there. Bit of activity. That there was what they call a Carolina. So as I was saying, hopefully we might get one or two fish. Get the old head torch back on. So there's one or two nosing about. So fingers crossed, we'll see what happens. Nice bream. Lovely bream. There we go. Beautiful fish. The other one's just bipped as well. There's one or two fish nosing about, which is good. So we'll get the baits back out on the spot, and we'll see what happens. Very nice too. Come on. Okay. I've just literally put one back. Is that shot off? And yeah, it's just spat the hook out. Not a bother. Is what it is. And yeah, a little bit frantic there. I thought I'd actually hook the line with the other rod. It turned out it was a fishy. So we'll get it all back out there and see if we can get one or two more. One or two to show the stamp I've been getting. Look at that beautiful fish. Lovely fish. Probably about 4 or 5 pound. Beautiful fish. Get one or two more. Gorgeous. And the nice fish. Well, good morning. This is the morning after the night before, so to speak. Well, it hasn't been too bad. I mean, I've had 15 bream. Could be 16. Hang on. Yeah, here we go. There we go. Skimmer. Smallest one so far. As I was saying, I've had 15 bream, about 5 pound, I suppose, is the biggest. So it's been quite enjoyable. Caught a few going up into dark. Just bear with. Oh, caught a few going up into dark. Come through the night, then had a little bit of a kip. Had a bit of a quartz spell, about 2 hours, so I had a bit of a kip. And yeah, just catching the odd fish, which is really, really nice. So I'm fishing me the old flatbed. There's the elasticated stem. And got my tail rubber. Tail rubber at top. The old specimen rod, absolutely beautiful bit of kit. Beautiful bit of kit. There's all the gubbins. You know, it's a powerful rod, but it's quite light blank as well. So I'm gonna load this up and get it back out there. So yeah, it's been a really eventful evening. In the morning as well. Get the old breakfast on the go in a minute. A lot of fish about last night, moving about. Didn't have many liners, which was really good because it showed that they were over the feed. There we go. All loaded up, ready to launch out. So yeah, like I was saying, morning after the night before, really good session again. Proper positive sort of tear off bites as well. No flapping about with it, sort of just a couple of beats and away. Was hoping might have picked up a tench, but still time. So it's only, it's 20 to 6, so probably another hour or so. I'm going to have some breakfast, have an hour or so, then pack everything together and head off for home. But yeah, looks like up to now it's been really, really enjoyable. Good catch, looks like it's on both rods as well, so I've probably got them about sort of 8 meters apart over that ground bait. As that was getting dark, you sort of look up the river where you could see the lights from the factory and factory units over the other side. Lot of fish moving about, lot of fish. And you could hear them boshing about as well. We had a couple of showers through the early hours, but nothing to worry about too much. I don't really think that I actually would have heard them anyway because I was Sparko. But right, let's get this back out there, see if we can get one or two more, get a bit of breakfast going, and I'll catch up with you before we go. Hee hee! Come on the fishes! Come on the tenches! Well, there we go. Just having a, oh, hello. Oh, a little bit of a liner. No, yes. Fish on. Oh. Perfect timing. Well, that's a nice way to end on a fish. Down on the mat. Well, as I was saying, was just having a slow pack up, and this fish just took hold. Beautiful river ouse bream to end the session on. Beautiful. So that's number 16. So we'll just get her back. There we go. Oh. As I say, that's a nice way to sort of end the video, really. It's number 16. So the 16 bream. Paul fishing further down. Been seeing him. He's had a lovely net. 14. Decent bream. Absolutely brilliant. So between us, we've had 30 bream. Old rowers. So between us we've had 30 bream. Yeah, I've lost a fish at the end, I think was a tench, that literally single tone straight into the pads. Not a lot I could do about it. But it's been, again, another eventful session. It's the first evening session up this part of the Ouse, and it's definitely paid off. So yeah, we'll get the gear together. I've got most of it sort of in an area where I want it, but we'll get the gear together, couple of trips back to the motor, and we've got some ground bait left, so that must mean we're gonna go fishing Sunday morning. So have a few hours Sunday. So if you're out this weekend, hope you have a few fish, and most importantly, just enjoy what you're doing. It don't matter what aspect of fishing that you're doing, just enjoy it. And on that note, Stevie is signing off. So I will catch you next time on the bank. Oosh.